Now, the judges' decisions are not always popular, but please understand that their decisions are based on their own personal taste and expertise of who will best represent New Jersey in the Miss USA pageant, which takes place in Miami. Once again, please remember that it is not the individual, but the cumulative totals of each competition that brings us our winners and runners-up. We believe that this year's panel of judges offer wonderful credibility to a very, very difficult task. And so, ladies and gentlemen, it is my pleasure to introduce to you our judges, beginning with Miss New York USA for 1982, who is now a fashion model and actress, Anne Marie Henderson. The director of advertising and marketing for the internationally famous Flemington Fur Company, Bob Benjamin. The fashion coordinator for many national TV specials, most recently Mrs. Woman of the World, which may be seen on January on WPIX TV Channel 11, Jean Bates. Vice President of Law for Broadcast Administration for the NBC Television Network, Alan Gerson. Miss New York USA 1984, who is currently doing postgraduate studies in communication at the University of Buffalo, Caroline Fleury. The Executive Vice President of the Agency for the Performing Arts in New York City, Harvey Litwin. And the Vice President and Manager of Commercial Casting for Darcy Macias Benton & Bowles Advertising Agency in New York City, Ruth DePasquale. Our lovely judge's assistant, Pamela Seitz. Also our official tabulator, with an associate with the certified public accounting firm of Rosenfeld, Hauptmann & Shields, Mr. Paul Shields. And other special guests in our audience this afternoon include the director of Serendipity Modeling School in Pompton Plains, Sue Zanstra. The fashion director of Buckner's in the Fashion Center Mall in Paramus, Lee Hellman. Of the Eastman Kodak Company, Harriet Smith. And our new director of promotions and appearances, Brenda Grennan. And also, ladies and gentlemen, the president of Sports Entertainment Media Corporation, Mr. Seymour Seitz.
Gentlemen, it's a pleasure to be here. I knew there was something wrong with that. It doesn't happen often that somebody is here to say, Joe DeRose, you do a terrific job. So usually that's one of the first things I do, and I would like Joe DeRose to hear nice applause. He is the only host I've ever worked with that actually stays with the girls from the first day they start rehearsing till the end. He is absolutely superb. I'm supposed to be here to do change of pace. And I promised Marilyn I wouldn't talk too much because she thinks that I talk too much when I get on stage. So I'm just going to do a terrific number that you're going to love. It's called You Always Hurt the One You Love.
You always hurt the one you love. The one you shouldn't hurt at all. You always take the sweetest rose and crush it till the petals fall.
Now, excuse me there, Mr. Carl Grayson. I'll tell this little girl all about this year's situation. Now, honey child, you know that you always seem to break the, very kind of soul of our heart with a hasty word that you just can't seem to recall. Honey child, honey lamb, honey baby, honey doll, honey pie. Now then, if this boy, now mind you, I says, if this here boy done broke your heart last night, honey child, honey lamb, honey baby, honey doll, honey pie, it's because he loves you the most of all.
Thank you. Your applause is worthwhile. This other song I'm doing was made famous by a very, very wonderful performer named Spike Jonze, who in the early days of your non-existence, he used to take songs that were terrific and destroy them. As he has destroyed this one too, I'm going to do it for you. The Destruction of Cocktails for Two.
To some exquisite chansonnette, two hands are sure to slyly meet beneath a serviette with cocktails for two. My head may go reeling, but my heart will be obedient with intoxicating kisses for the principal ingredient. Most any afternoon at five, we'll be so glad we're both alive. Then maybe fortune will complete the plan that all began with cocktails for two.
Thank you.
any afternoon at five.
Monday at five.
We'll be so glad we're both alive.
We're both so glad we're alive.
Then maybe fortune will complete
our plan that all began with cocktails.
Sights, ladies and gentlemen.